everyone! We're part of the UC Davis Arboretum and Public Garden Learning by Leading Gateways Outreach Team. My name is Emily.
Hi, I am Joyce.
Hi, I'm Jenny. And today we are introducing you to the amazing oak galls, their relationship with wasps, and how they are used by humans.
I always see those round objects hanging off oak trees. I wonder what they are.
Those are oak galls. They are formed when adult wasps lay their eggs in an oak tree, and the tree responds by producing galls that surround the eggs.
So that's a response from the tree? I didn't know that! But what about the eggs inside them?
The eggs will grow into larvae, which live and develop inside the galls. When they become mature, they will fly out through the little holes on the oak galls.
If you find an oak gall, look closely, and you'll see some tiny holes these wasps chewed when they left.
That's so cool! But wait, does this mean that the wasps are parasites to the tree?
Yes, since the larvae live inside the galls, they are kind of stealing nutrients from the tree, but they don't cause harm to the tree, like a mosquito bite. It is also rare for an oak tree to die solely from producing too many oak galls.
I see. This is so interesting! So, a gall wasp is like a mosquito, and an oak gall is like the puffy, reddish, and itchy bump I get after being bitten?
Yeah, exactly, you got it. And here's a fun fact. Oak galls come in extremely diverse sizes, shapes, and colors, depending on the species of wasp growing in them. They can be brown and round like a baseball, while some can be red, furry, and smaller than your fingernail. You can imagine an oak tree designing a customized crib unique to the larvae of the particular wasp species.
What? Google said there's over 1,000 species of gall wasps around the world. How does an oak tree know which species they are babysitting? Do they just know how to make these customized cribs?
Well, the larvae have the instructions inside of them. As these wasps' larvae grow, they release chemicals unique to their species. And the chemicals work like instructions that tell the tree how to grow their galls.
This is so cool! By the way, I heard that we can actually make ink or dye out of oak galls.
Wow, seriously? Making ink out of oak galls?
Yeah! So the general process of making oak gall dye or ink is to first take a few galls and break them into smaller pieces and soak them in hot water for a day or two until you see a nice brown dark color of the ink as tannins are being released from the galls. Some people would also add rust and lemon juice into the ink just to make it look darker and nicer.
Keep in mind though that this is just one of the many ways people make ink or dye out of galls, and that for thousands of years, people around the world, including Europe and North America, have been using different methods and approaches.
Right, now that is something very important to know.
Yes, and another fun fact about oak gall ink here. Oak gall ink was widely used by medieval scribes and was continually used for many historically important documents worldwide. In fact, the Constitution of the United States was written in oak gall ink.
Wow, that's so cool.
If you want to see real-life videos of oak galls and gall wasps, check out the Deep Look video below.
Want to see our oak information station in action? Watch the YouTube video of our team at Duck Days from earlier this year.
You can also walk around your backyard to search for oak galls and try making your oak gall ink at home. Link to the tutorial website and video in the description below.
Thanks for tuning in, everyone! We hope that you've learned something more about oak galls and how oak gall ink is made. Remember that oak galls are so awesome and interesting. Until next time, bye!